This whole concept of discipline is because we want to bring out the best. We all must suffer one of two pains in life, either the pain of discipline or the pain of regret.
Okay, we're here with our kitchen couples, Mike and Diane, Eric and Kara. Great to hear from Mom and Dad there. And there's lots of little nuggets of wisdom, and we'll have some more in a moment. But the whole area of discipline is very important, very huge in the life of a marriage
couple. It is. And you know what? We happen to have one of our kids with us today, Eric. And you, I'm going to pick on you for just a minute. You were the strongest willed of all the kids, okay? So you and I spent a lot of time together. I was a stay-at-home mom for a long period of time there, and we had a lot of conversations there, didn't we, honey?
Every time you got my name right. That's
Okay, I don't know why I would do that, but I would call you the wrong name.
The thing is, you would go, Andrea, Adam, Charlie, Bella, sorry, Eric, and Charlie. You got the dog's names before you got my name sometimes.
I'm sorry.
I totally understand.
I know. But okay.
Maybe that was a form of discipline.
Yeah, really. I'm going to stick with that.
But you know, feel neglected.
Okay, girls, he had me so kerflustered, I just couldn't get your name right. But no, you were very strong-willed, and I found that really you were the hardest one that I had to be consistent with in just discipline and keeping those boundaries in line. What are your memories of that time?
I'm now realizing that I created a lot of times for you to learn your parenting skills. So you're welcome. You're welcome for that. But no, I do
saying thank you. But anyway, it's okay.
I do remember those kind of times where, like, I would even try to stare you down sometimes because the thing is, I was so convinced that I was right.
Yes.
But you know, you are the mom, you are the parent.
And, now this is a 9-year-old. Okay.
But I would just be like, no, like I am right. And then be staring you down sometimes.
Yeah. And okay, I read Dr. Dobson's book, The Strong-Willed Child, and I'll get that for you, Kara, because
you.
The Lord is just, and He will give you one of these.
It's fine.
I love you, honey. What I'm saying is that I knew I had to win every time, right?
Yeah.
You know that when you've got a strong will to be consistent, you can't say you don't do that once and then they get away with it and there's no penalty or repercussion. I had to stare you down every time, honey. And did you ever have strong will?
Yes, ma'am. We had one that was very, and still is, very strong-willed and would not back down.
Yeah.
Would not back down at all. And it's challenging.
It is challenging.
Right? Because you have, as a parent, you have to stand your ground.
Mm-hmm.
And she's thinking that you told me I need to have a voice.
Yeah.
And I'm able to say what I want to say.
She's using your words against you.
Okay. And so she would be like, well, I'm just giving you my opinion. You said I can give you my opinion.
Yeah.
God,
and I think the beautiful thing about this whole process is that we don't worry about her today.
Yeah.
That's right.
I don't think you worry about Eric either.
Exactly.
So there are two kids who actually were able to pose their opinion.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And because they had parents who stood their ground and
That's
did
right.
those things. And so it is a really wonderful thing. And I want to say, for me, it's a little bit like coaching. The best coaches I had told me once. Right?
Mm-hmm.
And if you didn't get it right, then there are repercussions for that.
Mm-hmm.
And what I like
so
about
true.
The idea of coaching is, as a parent, right, what a coach does is a coach is trying to bring out the best. The coach isn't one to tell them what to do or make sure. No, they're just trying to bring out
the best
in them.
You.
And that's what we do as parents. This whole concept of discipline is because we want to bring out the best.
Mm-hmm.
They're saying, we all must suffer one of two pains in life, either the pain of discipline or the pain of regret. So we must remember that as parents as
well. That's good.
As much as kids don't like it and push against it, when you give them a boundary line, they're actually feeling
safe.
I'm loved. And there's safety there.
Yeah.
In the moment, they don't like it, they realize, you know, I think there's probably a reason. Maybe they really do love me.
Absolutely.
Maybe I need to obey.
We know better. Yeah. We know better. And we have to stand firm in that. Yeah. So we got a lot of wisdom to get from Mom and Dad.
Yeah, we'll go back and we'll hear from them. And this is, again, from their 50th anniversary, so it was a while back.
Yeah.
And this one is about conflict in marriage.
So you get yourself a bed or you got a touch. You can't sleep without at least once, at some point, touching your loved one.